Hello, in this video I'm going to teach you how to create a jagged array in Java. So let me explain what is a jagged array. Let's say we have an array 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 and 9. So this is a jagged array in which the row number 0 has only 3 elements, row number 1 has 4 elements, row number 2 has 4 elements. So this is a 2D array which has different number of elements in each row. Let's first understand what is a 2D array. So what is a 2D array? We can say 2D array is many 1D array. So let's say we have an array. So this is a 2D array. Or we can also say that in row number 0, there is a 1D array of size 3. In row number 1, there is 1D array of size 3. In row number 2, there is a 1D array of size 3. So we can also define 2D array in this way. So now we are going to use this concept to create a jagged array. So this is how we are going to do it. First, we are going to create a 2D array and then we are going to tell that, let's say this is A, we are going to tell that this 2D array at 0th row, we need only 2 elements. Or in this case 3 elements, and then we'll say that in this A array at index number 1 or row number 1 we need only 2 elements. In index number 2, that is row number 2, we'll need 4 elements. So this is what we are going to do. Let's see how we can do it in Java code. Let's create a 2D array of type int. So we'll say int A, so it is a 2D array, equal to new int. In this case, I'm going to only specify the number of rows. I'm going to leave this empty. So I'm going to tell that we have to create an array of 3 rows. So this is row number 1, 2 and 3. Next step is we are going to tell this 2D array's index number or row number 0 should contain, or we are going to create a 1D array inside it, equal to new int of size 3. Okay, so this line is going to create a 1D array of size 3 at row number 0. I'll say at row number 1, you create new array of size 2. So at row number 1, we are creating one array of size 2. Now same step for row number 2, I'm telling create a new int of size 4. So this will create this 1D array at row number 2. So this is how we are going to create this jagged array. Next we'll see how to take input for this jagged array. So we just saw that how to create a jagged array and our array's name was A. So how we are going to take input for this? So this is similar to how we take an input for a 2D array. There's nothing special for this. So what we used to do, we'll do int I equal to 0 and I should be less than A is the array dot length. So this is how we get the row, and inside that we'll use one more nested for loop. Here we'll say J equal to 0. Here comes a tricky part, but I believe most of you people must have done this. So what I'm going to do is A I, so if it is 0, so A of 0, that is in row number 0 dot length. So what it will give me? 1, 2, 3. Okay. So when row is 1, when I is 1, so here it will be A of 1 dot length. So A of 1 dot length will give me 2. Okay. And then the next iteration, I will be 2. So A of 2 will be, A of 2 dot length will be 4. So this is how we are going to do this. Then J++, finish it off. Now we are going to take the input from the user. Or instead of taking input from the user, I'm going to use a count variable. I'll say int count equal to 0. And in this place, A of I and j, I'm going to put this count and increment it. Okay, so I'll close the for loops. So this is going to generate this kind of jagged array with this input. Now next, let's see how to print this jagged array. So printing is also same. So instead of putting values inside the array, I'm just going to remove this line, and now I'll just print it over here. I'm going to reuse the same code, A of I and j, and we'll need some space. And then after the first for loop, I'm going to leave a line. So this is how you can print this array. So if you learned something from this video, please leave a like and consider subscribing to my channel. Thank you.